In this video, we will cover binning 2D data using the binning 2D module. Binning 2D requires that data already has coordinates and elevations applied. You can start binning directly after the geometry application module, or by loading in a dataset that already has coordinates and station numbers for source and receiver applied. Set your bin increments to an appropriate value for your input data. The crooked line bin increment works best if you set it to a value close to your bin increment for straight line data. These settings will adjust the parameters of your crooked binning line and slalom line. Typography smoothing distance affects the topography of your stack line. If you want no smoothing, set this to 0. Otherwise, higher numbers represent a wider smoothing aperture. You can see the result of changing this parameter in the CMP topography vista here. Max distance here represents the width of your bins, from the center stack line to the outer edge. I'm going to run my binning 2D module now. If you get this error when you run binning 2D, first try increasing the grid size of the slalom line, or reduce your slalom smoothing distance before addressing other potential causes. The slalom smoothing distance shouldn't be more than 3 times the grid size. Qcr Bin Grid using the vistas produced by the binning 2D module. You can see the placement of your bins relative to your CDP points on the map. The CMP fold vista shows you the overall distribution of CMP points on that grid. The angle direction GUI gives you an indication of how the direction of your line changes over its length. If you wish to import a previously existing bin grid, switch to Simple Import Binning from Text File, and then go to Import Crooked Line. You can import a .dat or slalom file, or a simple text file. Your input text file should be 3 columns, the first with CMP number, followed by columns for CMPX and CMPY. When using this option, the module properties values that define your binning and crooked line will not be considered for your final binning. You can save any component of your binning module to the database for use later by right-clicking on the item and selecting Save to DB. Please check out some of our other tutorial videos or visit us at geomage.com.